September 18th, Isaiah chapter 4, verses 2 to 6. On that day, the branch of the Lord will be luster and glory, and the fruit of the earth will be honor and splendor for the survival of Israel. He who remains in Zion, and he that is left in Jerusalem, will be called holy. Everyone will be marked down for life in Jerusalem. When the Lord washes away the filth of the daughters of Zion and purges Jerusalem's blood from her midst with a blast of searing judgment, then will the Lord create over the whole site of Mount Zion and over her place of assembly a smoking cloud by day and a light of flaming fire by night. For over all, his glory will be shelter and protection, shade from the parching heat of the day, refuge and cover from storm and rain. After God's trust in his people had hit the lowest point, the time for reconstruction could begin. His new plan was Mount Zion for the remnant people who had remained faithful. The symbol for the protective presence of God is the cloud. These people are the poor in spirit, who were prepared to stay close to God. They knew that they were totally reliant upon God. Joseph and Mary belonged to this group of people called Anabim. The poor in spirit. In his humility, Joseph also had the courage of faith to choose God and to remain close to him. Like those before him, the glory of God shone through his faith and his trust.